Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I want to use Word and create new styles. Okay, so when you're working with a Word document, you have access to a number of built-in styles, and I use some of these quite often. So there's title styles and several heading styles and quite a few others. But let's say you want to create your own brand new styles for a particular job that you're working on. So let's say I've got a document here and I am regularly putting in long quotations, block quotes, and I want to style these a little different. I'm not doing some official APA or MLA paper, so I want to be a little bit more creative with how the styles look for my block quotes or long quotations. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up the style dialog box that pops open over to the side here. And by the way, I'm just clicking on the little command group to open that. And I have a bunch of styles down here, but at the bottom of this menu there is a create new style button. When you create new styles, you have a few little form fields to fill out. The name of my new style is going to be long quote. I'm going to go ahead and make it a paragraph style, since this particular kind of text is going to be separated from surrounding paragraphs as opposed to a character style. I'll go ahead and base it off of the normal, call it long quote. And then I can decide, well, how do I want this long quote to look? I'm going to use a slightly different font. I'll use a scripty font. I don't know if I'm going to dig that, but we'll go for it anyway. I'll keep the standard font size and font color and italics, but then I'm going to hit the format button in the lower left corner. I'm going to change paragraph styles. And for the indentation on the left, I'll do 1 inch. And on the right, 1 inch. For line spacing, I'll stick with single. Click OK. And let's do something else real quick. I'll do format, borders, change the shading a little bit, and I'll just do a light gray shading. Click OK. Click OK. Excellent. So now I have this long quote style available to me. Now I don't want to use this long quote style right now, so I'll jump back over to my normal style, and I could just be typing along a regular paragraph. I'm going to use a little built-in Word function to put in some lorem ipsum text. So now I've got my document, but really this is going to be a long quote from somebody. So I'll just, in fact, I don't even need to select the paragraph. I could just click anywhere in this paragraph and apply my long quote style, and now it's got that particular style. Of course, I should put in my quotation marks and cite the author and things like that, but that's how easy it is to create a style. Now I'm going to do another one here. A very similar situation. Let's say I'm writing a document, a report, and I regularly need to put in some code samples, whether it's HTML or JavaScript or something like that. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new style, open up my styles dialog box, and I'll create a new style, and this is going to be a code sample. I'll still use a paragraph style. This time I'm going to use Courier New, which is a fixed width font. I'm going to up that to a 12. I'll use a bold, change the color to a red, maybe a green looks a little better, and I'll do format border. I'm going to put a border along the, I will choose a thicker border. Just put a border along the left. Yeah, I think that'll work for me. Click OK. Go back to my normal style. Now when I'm typing along and I'm ready to put in a sample of code, well, I can simply switch over to my code sample, and now I can put in the various, you know, the HTML that I might be wanting to type. So modifying styles comes in handy in a number of situations. For instance, if I were to type in a web address, of course Word will style it like a hyperlink, blue and underlined. But of course, if I know I'm printing this report out, that's not going to be very helpful to me. So what I can do is I can go to the styles dialog box, find the hyperlink style, modify it, and instead of using blue text, I can use black text that's not underlined. So the hyperlink is still there. I could still do a control click to follow it, but it's going to print much better on a black and white laser. So create styles and modify them when necessary.